When NBC launched Peacock last year, many of us wondered if we really needed yet another streaming service.
Yeah, and now that the NBC streaming service is here and we've had a year to play around with it, we can say whether or not Peacock TV is a good place to watch free TV and movies, or if you'll need to look elsewhere.
In this Peacock review, we walk through the app, talk about what it's like to watch it on your TV, tablet, and phone, cover what comes with the free, premium, and premium plus plans, and help you decide whether or not those paid services are a good option for you.
Yeah, and if you want to know how to stretch your streaming budget to make sure you get the most for your money, hang with us to the end, where we'll share the secret streaming services don't want you to know about and show you how you can use it to save even more money every month.
All right, let's get started with the Peacock plans and what's included with each. Now, Peacock has three plans: Peacock, which is free, Peacock Premium, which costs $4.99 a month or $49.99 a year, and Peacock Premium Plus for $9.99 a month or $99.99 a year. NBC says you can get about two-thirds of its content free. The other third requires a paid plan.
What comes with every plan? You get thousands of hours of movies and TV, exclusive content that's only on Peacock, plus news and sports. There's also a good bit of content for kids, as well as Spanish language content from Telemundo. Peacock Premium includes all of that, plus live sports from the Premier Soccer League, exclusive original series, next day access to current NBC hits, and more movies and TV shows. You'll also enjoy full access to all of Peacock's movies and TV shows for kids. This is significant because it includes everything DreamWorks has made for kids and a lot of great content.
That's right. Now, a Peacock Premium plan gets you every episode of The Office, Parks and Rec, Suits, and every other show on Peacock. The commercials will be the same between the free and premium plan. If you want ad-free content and the ability to download shows to watch offline, you'll have to sign up for Peacock Premium Plus for $9.99 a month or $99.99 a year.
Yeah, but what are the commercials like in the free and premium content?
Actually, not that bad. NBC says it runs less than 5 minutes of ads per hour of content you watch. When I clicked in an older movie that's about 2 hours long, there were 6 45-second commercial breaks in it and a 20-second clip before it started.
That's not as many interruptions as you'll find on CBS-backed free TV streaming service Pluto. And on some shows, NBC will run 3 minutes of ads at the beginning and then air the rest ad-free, which is a nice feature. And it's not that different from other similarly priced streaming services like Discovery Plus and Hulu, which also run ads during shows and movies.
Now let's dive into the Peacock app and what it's like to use it. Now, I've reviewed a lot of streaming services, and I have to say that Peacock has a really smooth look and feel. You can create a free account with just an email address, so you don't need a credit card to sign up. When you sign in on a computer, smart TV, or tablet, you'll see a few featured shows at the top of the screen and a row of options at the very top that include channels, browse, and featured, which are the three main ways that Peacock organizes its shows and movies. Those categories are followed by movies, TV shows, sports, WWE, kids, news, and Latino. Browse is the default view for bigger screens. Channels is the view you see first when you watch on your phone. Browse is pretty typical for streaming services and probably what you're used to seeing if you've watched others. As you scroll down, you'll see categories like Peacock Picks, Just Added, Featured Films, Oscar-winning movies, original content, comedies, dramas, crime, current TV, and more.
Like we said earlier, with a free subscription, you won't get all the content for all the shows. Current shows may give you the latest episode for free. Take Chicago Fire, for example. A free plan offers 189 episodes from seasons 1 through 9, with the most recent free episode being number 11.
And if you browse SNL content, you won't be able to watch the most recent week's episode right away unless you sign up for Peacock Premium. You get a lot of back seasons and the episode before last, but not the most recent. So that's a bummer, but again, it's free, so you can't really complain too much.
Very true. One thing that we do like about Peacock is the extra content they put with shows. On any show or movie, you can see more titles like what you're viewing, as well as collections of clips, trailers, and extras for many items. Clicking on any show title lets you watch it with the show or movie previewing in the top portion of the screen on your phone or computer. There are lots of popular shows and movies like The Office, Parks and Rec, 30 Rock, Suits, Downton Abbey, and movies like Matrix, Jurassic Park, and Jason Bourne.
Yeah, now there are two things you'll notice as you're looking at titles. First, clicking on any title will bring up a screen where just beneath the title, you will see a film's Rotten Tomatoes score as well as its Flixster rating. So for Bridesmaids, for instance, you'll see that 90% of people on Rotten Tomatoes liked it, and 76% of people did on Flixster. That can be helpful when you're trying to decide whether or not something is worth watching. Another important icon to look for is a purple triangle with a white feather in the top left corner of a movie or TV show. That indicates premium content. So, in the movies section, you can watch Fences for free, but you'll need a paid account to watch Catch Me If You Can or Ride Along. The difference becomes more noticeable in the kids section, where a number of movies require a paid subscription.
That's a good point, Nicole. Let's talk quickly about the news section. If you've watched our Paramount Plus review, you may remember that you get 4 live stations of CBS when you subscribe for that streaming service. While it does start at $5.99 a month, you will get access to a live CBS News stream. That's not the case with Peacock. Even the paid tiers won't give you live streams of NBC or NBC News. Instead, you'll get access to NBC News Now, which NBC calls a streaming news network. It carries the biggest stories as well as deep dives into various topics that will run about a few minutes in length. It's not bad, but it's not your local NBC station like you'll get for CBS when you subscribe to Paramount Plus.
Yeah, and that doesn't change if you sign up for a paid plan with Peacock. You still won't get your local NBC station. If you want that, the best way to get it, as well as all your local channels without cable, is to buy an antenna. For one low upfront cost, you can get all your local channels free for life. If you want to learn more about antennas and cutting the cord, watch our video on that now. There are 2 more categories worth taking a look at on Peacock, and that's Latino and WWE. NBC put a lot of work into its Latino offerings and launched with over 3,000 hours of Spanish language content, including originals produced by Univision. That's pretty cool. Now you will notice right away that to access some of the more popular shows and original content, you'll need to sign up for Peacock Premium, but it is still a really robust collection of content.
Okay, now this last content category might not interest everyone, but it is significant. WWE. Not only can you watch every WrestleMania ever, Peacock is the exclusive streaming home of the WWE Network. So if having that channel is important to you, you'll love Peacock. While you can get some WWE content for free, you see pretty quickly that a paid subscription gives you much more. For $4.99 a month, you'll unlock every live WWE pay-per-view event, including WrestleMania, SummerSlam, and Royal Rumble. You can also watch every episode of Raw and SmackDown with current full episode replays 30 days after they air.
Now, what's nice about that is that every pay-per-view WWE event is included in your Peacock Premium subscription. So if you like wrestling, that alone could make Peacock worth it to you. There's one more way Peacock organizes its content, and that's through the channels view. When you click on it, or when you open the app on your phone, you'll see content display in the top half of the screen and a channel guide below it. There are a few things here that are kind of annoying and honestly detract from this view. First, there's no way to maximize the channel guide. And if you linger on something for more than a few seconds, it goes away, and you have to click back to see it again.
Yeah, that is wonky. Plus, the content isn't live. It's just kind of trying to make you feel like it is. You can see what's on right now and will be on that channel in the next hour. In all, there's about 45 channels. Some are dedicated to a single show like Today All Day, SNL Vault, and Fallon Tonight. Others are dedicated to specific sports like NBC Golf Pass. While others are still just content categories, you can find in the browse section displayed like channels that continuously stream that content, like SNL Vault or WWE.
Yeah, you know, John, it reminds me of a cross between Pluto TV and Discovery Plus. Like we mentioned in our Discovery Plus review, that streaming service has channels dedicated to a particular show that just runs every episode around the clock, like House Hunters International or Property Brothers. You can learn more about Discovery Plus in our review now. And this view could be helpful for people who are used to cable and like finding content through a channel guide as opposed to show titles. But I think the way Peacock does it is wonky, and it really could benefit from some improvement.
Okay, so we're at the end of our video, and it's time for our verdict on Peacock and our secret that streaming services don't want you to know. First, the secret. Many people who cut the cord and switch to streaming do so with a cable mindset. They forget that you can start and stop whenever you want. You can cancel at any time with no fee.
Yeah, or you can pause your service so you don't lose your viewing history.
Yeah, you can watch for a month, then pause your subscription for 3 months, then start up again. You don't have to just pay mindlessly each month.
Yeah, and you shouldn't. So let's wrap up with which Peacock plan is right for you. If you don't mind commercials and you like NBC content, go with the free plan. Try it for a month or two and see how many shows you want to watch require that premium plan. If you find again and again that you're not able to watch what you want, it may be worthwhile to sign up for Peacock Premium. You probably won't need the Premium Plus plan unless all of your favorite shows are on NBC and you want to be able to watch them ad-free. And if you're watching on your phone, consider turning the stream over to Wi-Fi only option in the settings to avoid eating up your data if you don't have an unlimited data plan on your phone service.
Yeah, and if you're looking for an easy way to save on your phone service, watch our Mint Mobile review. Their unlimited data plan is just $30 a month.
Now, Peacock is yet another streaming service in a very crowded space. If you like NBC shows and popular movies, give the free service a try. And if you like this video, be sure to hit that red subscribe button so you can be notified of all our new content.
Thanks for watching, and we'll see you in our next video.